Hey everybody, and welcome to a quick thoughts video here on Sunday, September 27th, 2015. Thanks for joining me here today on the channel. Just wanted to give you guys a quick video that was not just a raw review and was a little bit of a topical video, but yet one that isn't too over the top long either. So that's kind of what this concept is. I did one last month on Neville and his character. And this month I want to talk about Cody Rhodes and how I believe that the Stardust gimmick is actually holding him back quite a bit. I'm sure I'm not in the minority when I say that Cody Rhodes is a great talent and that he's the type of guy who could be a main event style player for WWE, could be a world champion, etc. So, and by the way, this topic was actually brought to my attention by D-Wolf Lycanus in the last quick thoughts video I did. He mentioned that he'd like to see a thoughts video on Cody Rhodes and whatnot, and I think that it's a great concept. It's something that doesn't get talked about a whole lot right now, I feel like, not as much as it should be getting talked about. Stardust is a really cool gimmick for Cody. He has played it extremely well. Let's not lie. He's actually proven over the last 3-4 years that he can play a lot of different gimmicks really effectively, whether that be an insane son of a bitch or a guy who, you know, can put bags over people's heads, a dashing Cody Rhodes, you know, and then being a babyface with Goldust in a tag team and now turning into Stardust and playing an outlandish gimmick extremely well. He's run the gamut, and he's played every gimmick really, really well, both as a face and as a heel, and been very effective in both roles. However, I think this is the time for him to finally make that leap to the big push of his career. I feel like the zenith of his career is right around the corner for him, and it starts with transforming back to Cody Rhodes. The crowd keeps chanting for it. There's been little, you know, subtle teases of it over the course of time. They've been quite subtle. You really got to look at it from a certain perspective, I feel, to really see those subtle feelings of, oh, will he turn? And you always got to wonder, will he turn back into Cody Rhodes? They've really, you know, played up to it, especially with the crowd chants continuing on. The people want it. The fans want it. Everybody wants it. It's got to happen. It really has got to happen. And I think the Stardust gimmick is really great. And it's honestly a shame because if it was used better than this jobber, irrelevant character that it is right now, then maybe I wouldn't even be saying that he needs to transform back into the Cody Rhodes that he once was. But with his father, Dusty, passing away earlier this year, with the fact that him and his brother had a feud that never went anywhere, never happened at WrestleMania as it was supposed to, nothing between the two ever really went anywhere. They had a feud that completely dropped off the face of the earth. After all that has happened, this is the time. This is the time to turn this man back into the Cody Rhodes that we once knew. And I think the main reason why that needs to happen is because he's not a main eventer as Stardust. He's a mid-carder, and a good mid-carder at that, don't get me wrong. But the true potential of Cody Rhodes is beyond the mid-card. It's beyond the Stardust gimmick. He is far and away one of the best talents WWE has to offer right now. Absolutely, no question, hands down, one of the best people in the company. He's solid on the microphone, very solid in the ring. He improved over our eyes, you know, over the course of time. 2007, 2008, you know, he was pretty green, pretty new, young guy, didn't have a whole lot of experience, was part of a couple of tag teams with Hardcore Holly, and then, you know, with DiBiase, and then with the Legacy, and then we just saw Cody Rhodes explode into a superstar. And trust me, when Legacy was finishing up, you thought Ted DiBiase Jr. was going to be the big star out of the two. And it was absolutely not true. It was Cody Rhodes who became the big star, and Ted DiBiase ended up leaving wrestling. It's crazy how that ended up working out, but everybody was thinking about DiBiase because he did. He really did have all the tools, and it's too bad it didn't work out for him the way it really should have. But Cody Rhodes, honestly, is better in every way, and that includes in the ring, that includes on the microphone. He has a great persona to him. He can, you know, elicit cheers, he can elicit boos. He's very good at being both a babyface and a heel. He's proven that over the course of time. I think it's time for him to become a babyface as Cody Rhodes, and for the layers of Stardust to peel off one at a time. And I don't even care if that all culminates in a feud with Goldust whenever he's ready to return. That brother versus brother feud still needs to happen as far as I'm concerned. I still want those two guys to face each other, whether it's WrestleMania, Survivor Series, Royal Rumble, I don't care where it is. But those two guys facing off really should happen still in a bigger match situation that has a culminating point to it. So I really hope that will eventually happen. But I think Cody Rhodes is a Royal Rumble winner. You know, he should be winning a Royal Rumble and main eventing WrestleMania and winning the belts. I really would love that. And I think that, I'm not saying it will happen, but I would certainly love for it to happen for 2016. It would be great to have a semblance of character development away from the Stardust character and closer to the Cody Rhodes character over the remainder of this year, with a Royal Rumble victory and then a WrestleMania title victory. This can be the Rhodes legacy. You know, again, kind of tying back to the legacy that he does have. Not making it all about the fact that he's the son of Dusty Rhodes, because he's proven time and time again that he doesn't need to be the son of Dusty Rhodes in order to be successful. He has proven that in many, many different ways. And that's what's been so impressive about Cody Rhodes, is that you don't even think about him being Dusty Rhodes' son. Honestly, when I think about it, I'm like, they are? They're related? Like, wow, that's crazy. Like, I remember thinking about that even early on in Cody Rhodes' tenure in WWE, thinking to myself, man, he just doesn't feel like the son of Dusty Rhodes. They don't even need to mention it. He's good enough on his own. And that's something that has been an unbelievably remarkable quality about the guy. And yeah, there has been plenty of mentions over the course of time, but this is the time to make him the guy who will carry on the legacy that his father left behind. When his father passed away, I wanted Dusty Rhodes, after Dusty Rhodes had passed, for Cody to drop the Stardust gimmick then and start this path. But it's not too late at all, and Cody should be a big babyface and could easily be one of the biggest and most important faces in the company. Imagine him going against Seth Rollins in a feud for the belt. It would be really, really fun stuff, and it would be a great match that is just waiting to happen. It's waiting to write itself in. Honestly, it would be great stuff. So Cody Rhodes, without a question, has all the great qualities of what a babyface can be going forward. He has the legacy on his side, he has the character ability on his side, and peeling away Stardust and moving back into the Cody Rhodes that, you know, that we once knew, even though there's been so many different versions of Cody Rhodes, the Cody Rhodes that we once knew, and just unlocking that true potential as a potential main event star or big level type of wrestler for WWE going forward. I think they are shooting themselves in the foot. I think they are selling themselves short by having him continue to go out there as Stardust in an irrelevant mid-card feud, by having him continue to be featured in a way that isn't big enough for a guy with so much talent in so many different ways. The guy's too good to be used in this way. And if he was going to be used as Stardust, at least, you know, continue to develop that character, at least continue to have him in feuds that actually feel somewhat important. But it is far beyond too late for the Stardust character to be the pinnacle of Cody Rhodes. That it was never going to be the pinnacle of Cody Rhodes, but it had potential to at least be a pretty good piece of the career of Cody Rhodes, whereas it's actually been pretty forgettable because of the fact that he has been booked really, you know, wishy-washy, up and down, all over the place. And this is the time. This is the time to turn him into the babyface. So he could be one of the biggest faces of your company. He could be one of the next big guys going for your company over the next few years. I 100% feel that way. So let me know what you guys think about Cody Rhodes. Let me know what you guys think would be the best thing for him, what you like about him, what you don't like about him, etc. Down below in the comments. Be sure to give me a like if you enjoyed the video, and of course, subscribe for plenty more. Thanks for watching, and until next time, peace.